So we'll start with the next experiment named as bevel protractor. So this is a bevel protractor which we are using for the measurement of angle. Right. So the different parts of this bevel protractor are: this is the main body, and this is the stack or the support, and this is the locking nut, and this is the rotating pin. Right. So along with this one, the number of divisions what we are going to observe on the body, that is nothing but main scale reading. Along with that one, we will be having the reading on the vernier scale also, right? So which we can rotate, right? So in the vernier scale, at the center we are having the zero reading, and towards the right side we'll be having till 60, as well as towards the left we'll be having 60 numbers. That is nothing but 12 divisions will be splitted into 60, that is minutes, and on the left side also same thing, right? That means one smallest division on the vernier scale is going to give a 5 minute. That is the least count of this vernier scale, right? So we can see in this formula how to calculate the least count. That is the formula what we are having is smallest division on the main scale, that is 60, right? So this is in terms of minutes. That is a smallest division is 1 degree. 1 degree is nothing but 60 minutes, and total number of divisions on the vernier scale, how many total number of divisions we are having, that is we need to consider or only on the left or on the right side, that is 12 divisions. So 12 fives are 60, that is 5 minutes. This is the least count of this bevel protractor, right? So let us go for measuring the angle of the specimen, right? So in order to measure the lengthier workpieces, we'll be using the larger blades. In order to measure the angle of smaller workpieces, we are going to use the smaller blades, right? So let us see. The blades consist of the slot. In this slot, the pin has to settle down, right? So in this manner we are going to arrange it, and first let us see whether the surface plate is perfectly horizontal or not, right? So we can see the reading here, it is showing exactly zero. That means whatever the surface plate, we are going to use it as a reference for our measurement, that is perfectly flat, and it is showing the zero reading here, right? So that is the check what we can do. Next one, we are going to measure the angle of this specimen by keeping the lower edge of this blade which it directly contact with the top surface of the specimen, right? So this is the specimen what we are having, right? There should not be any gap between the lower edge of the blade as well as the top surface of the specimen, right? So along with that one, we should go for owing in such a manner that our stock should exactly touch the bottom reference plate, right? So I'm going to lock it, and I'm going to take the reading now, right? So which is showing exactly how much? A 4 minute, and next one, 4 minute is the main scale reading, and vernier scale reading that is 15, right? So the third line is going to be exactly coincided, that is nothing but 15, right? So we'll write it in the observation, that is main scale reading, that is 4 degrees, and the vernier scale division is 3. The least count of this one is 5 minutes. So this is 15 minutes, right? The total reading is 4 degree 15 minutes, right? So this is how we are going to take the readings for 4 to 5 specimen, right? So next specimen what we will consider is, we need to check the angle plate. Before that one, will go for using. So next specimen is this wooden piece. I am going to measure this included angle between this surface and this inclined surface. That can be done using a smaller blade, right? So in this manner we should held that in such a way that the bottom portion or the stack portion should contact or directly in touch with the top surface, and this edge of this blade should directly touch with the surface. There should be a surface contact, not a point contact, right? So we are going to measure the included angle between this stock as well as this blade, right? So I will lock it, I will lock the reading, and let us go for taking the reading, right? So which is nothing but, so this is 80, 90. After 90 we'll be having 80, that means that is 100, right? So we'll be having, so once again I will show you how to take the reading, right? So interior angle or the exterior angle, right? So initially we'll be having the zero reading when it is exactly horizontal, right? Now I will fix this bevel protector in order to measure the angle, right? So now we have moved it from 0 to where, around something 76 or 77, right? So let us take the reading, and now whatever the angle we are moving from 0 to 70, that is nothing but the exterior angle. If you need this angle, right, so whatever the angle we got, that has to be subtracted from 180 degree in order to get this included angle, right? So otherwise the another method is we can measure or we can take the reading in this manner also. That is also one of the method what we are having in order to measure the angle, right? So now we will lock it and we will go for measuring what is the angle we will be getting, right? So 76 is the main scale, and 30 minutes is my vernier scale reading, right? So 76 degrees and the 30 is my minute. Directly you can write it as 30, or else 6th division it has been coincided into the least count, 5 will be having. So we'll write it as 76 degrees 30 minutes, right? So these two are the specimens. Similarly we can go for measuring the other specimen angle also. This is one more wooden piece what we are having. In order to measure the angle between these two surfaces, these two slot surfaces, we should held in this manner, right? So it is going to give the included angle between the stack as well as the blade, right? So this is the third specimen, right? So next one, similarly if you want to cross check the angle of this angle plate, we are going to keep the stack on the top surface and we will rotate this blade until it touches with the side surface, right? So we can observe from the reading, right? So it is going to give exactly the 90 degree. That means the included angle whatever we are having between these two surfaces, that is 90 degree, right? So even we can check the angle of this V block also, right? So see here, this is the V block what we are having, and this is the stacking arrangement. But here there should be a surface contact between the lower edge of the blade with respect to the angle, right? So whatever the angle we can observe here, see here the reading whatever we are observing, that is showing exactly the 45 degrees, right? So that means the included angle between the V block is exactly the 45 degrees, right? So this is how we are going to take the readings for the different specimens, and that will be noted in the results section also, right? So this is how we will measure the angle of different specimens using the bevel protractor.